Hey guys, today we're gonna talk about Dollar General, ticker symbol DG, one of my favorite stocks and, in my opinion, a great company to invest for the long run. In this video, I'm gonna talk about the company history, some of their key financial metrics and competitive advantages. The company went public in 2009. If you had bought a share then, you would have paid $22. As you can see, it has almost been a 10-bagger since then, with a stock trading at $204. Dollar General is a retail company that was founded in 1939 and today is headquartered in Goodlettsville, Tennessee. At the beginning, the owner of Dollar General noticed that some companies in the city increased their sales a lot when they decided to make promotions. That's when he had a simple but brilliant idea. Why not start a company where everything is always on sale, every day? It was then that the company's concept came up, to sell products that cost less than $1. Time has passed and this idea, which came from the beginning, has not yet changed. Today, most of the company's products sell for up to $5 and are divided into four categories. Consumables, which are basically cleaning products, packaged and perishable foods, that represent the majority of the company's revenue, with 76.8%. Seasonal, which are toys, gardening products and others, with 12.1% of revenue. Home products, which are kitchen materials and household items. And apparel, which are children's clothing and clothing for men and women. The company has grown a lot. Today, it has more than 157,000 employees, over 17,000 stores spread all over the entire American territory. It has a sales model for cheap products. 22% of them are sold for less than $1. The formats of the stores vary a lot to suit the location and to adapt to the target audience of each region. The company is ranked 112 in the Fortune 500 list. They had $33 billion in sales in 2020, which led to $2.7 billion net income. Let's take a look at how the company has managed to expand over the years. In 1994, it had more or less 2,000 stores, and it was growing quite aggressively. In 2018, it already had almost 16,000 stores, and today the number of stores is over 17,000. We can also see that the distribution centers are almost all located on the East Coast of the US. The company's major differential is that 75% of the stores are located in small cities with a maximum of 20,000 inhabitants. Dollar General does not want to compete directly with industry giants like Walmart and Costco, for example. Instead, they focus on a very specific niche, the public in small cities with medium or low income that none of the big competitors want or cannot meet. Let's think about this for a moment. Walmart stores, for example, have an average size of 35,000 square feet. They can't build a store like that in a small town because they won't have enough customers. Dollar General stores are much smaller, with an average size of 1,500 square feet. With this, they are able, at a much lower cost, to serve this very specific niche in the market. The idea is, find in our stores what you need in the shortest possible time, spending less for it. Another great advantage of the company is that in small cities the cost of properties is much lower, whether to buy or to lease, and that is why they are able to grow so much and so fast. Because they are present in small cities and have very few big competitors, it is almost as if customers are forced to buy into Dollar General stores. For small purchases, traveling to a larger city does not pay. This makes it possible for the company to save expenses, for example, with customer service or with the perfect storage of products in stores. They don't need any of this. The company's concept is, customers come in, they buy cheap products very quickly and can leave the store. With regard to sales, we can see that sales have only increased over time every year since 1994. This chart right here is my favorite. It is the same store sales chart. As the company has been growing the number of stores, the same store sales is an interesting metric because it allows to compare the sales performance without considering the variation in the number of stores from one year to the next. At a first glance, the graph does not draw much attention, an average increase of about 6% per year. But pay attention to this. This chart shows the growth of sales in relation to the previous year. Let me repeat because this is important. The company has managed for almost 30 years to consecutively surpass the same store sales of the previous year. It is just fantastic. I've never seen anything like this. And look what happened to them because of the pandemic. Same store sales rose mind-blowing 16.3% in 2020 from the previous year. The company trades at a price-to-earnings ratio of 19. We can also see here the company's margins. Despite working with low margins, as it is part of the retail sector, which has this characteristic, its net margins is 7.9%, well above the average of competitors. Costco, for example, has a net margin of only 2.4%. To conclude, let's have a look at the summary of the company and understand why I think it is still a growth stock and an excellent investment opportunity for the long term. They have more than 30 consecutive years of same-store sales growth. Stores are present in low-rent areas. They are small, cheaper to expand, with low cost of acquisition and maintenance. Stores are built to suit. They are close to customers, selling cheap products. There's no need to spend with the excellence of the service or with the tidiness of the stores, for example, because customers are almost forced to buy a Dollar General in smaller cities. And they have a quick purchase model for the customer, in and out quickly. So what do you think? Is Dollar General a stock buy? Please let me know in the comments. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please don't forget to smash the like button and subscribe to the channel for videos of some of the greatest companies to invest. See you next time.